Hi, everyone. This is Nathan with the Paula's Choice research team here with this week's edition of Beauty Talk. So we all know that skincare can get a little tricky at times, especially when you're trying to, find that right product for your concerns, especially when concerns are things like anti-aging or discolorations. And it can be made even trickier when it comes to misinformation that you can find on the internet. So that is what today's segment is all about, the misinformation that retinol cannot be combined with acidic ingredients like vitamin C or AHA or BHA. So we're going to explain why this is a myth, why you can use retinol with these types of ingredients, and then how to get the most out of your retinol routine. So the first thing is we'll look at the myth. The myth is that, again, you can't combine retinol with vitamin C products or with AHA or BHA exfoliants. And the claim is that these acidic ingredients has an impact on the pH of skin, and retinol is less able to do its work. So there's only one study that is used or cited about with this claim or this rumor, and it's from 1990, and it doesn't even have anything to do with topically applied retinol products. The long story made short, you're welcome, is that the study used a combination of human cells and animal cells, animal proteins, to look at how retinol that's naturally present in human and animal skin and how it actually goes about doing its antioxidant function in skin. So with that, they describe, the best pH level is, the pH level that's already naturally present in your body, which is about 5 or so, right along there. And they said, well, okay, retinol works the best at this pH because that's your healthy body's pH. It in no way was meant to be taken out of context like this to say that you shouldn't apply retinol topically, with products that have a lower pH. So that's absolutely not the case. So don't worry about that. Now, the reason why we do know that that is not the case is that there is quite a lot of research that shows retinol does work very well with acidic ingredients like vitamin C. It can also be combined with AHA or BHA exfoliants without any concern, and a lot of that research is very, very recent, and it is repeated again and again and again. You can read more about that in detail in the article in the comment section below. So now that we know why the myth is not true, I'm going to tell you about how to get the best from your particular retinol product. It really kind of depends on what retinol you're using. If you're using a really potent retinol, your skin may not be able to tolerate it using it every day, so you're just going to kind of have to find that frequency that works best for you. For some people, using retinol, once, twice, or three times a week, depending on the formula, is the right frequency for them. For milder retinol formulas, you might be able to use it every day. The bottom line is you want to use it consistently and that you're patient with the results. It didn't take a week or 2 weeks or a month for your signs of aging or damage to show up, so it's not going to take, it's going to take a little bit longer than that for those results to show up as well. So it's a long-term relationship. You want to keep using your retinol formula on a regular basis and just make sure that you're not combining it with irritating formulas. Things that have a lot of fragrances in them, things that are alcohol-based, can all have a negative impact on skin, and you can also reduce the effectiveness that you see from your particular retinol. Don't forget to wear sunscreen every day because the sun's damage is really going to undo all of the work you're trying to correct with your retinol. So I hope that was helpful. Again, for more information, you can check out the more info section below. This is Nathan with the Paula's Choice research team. Thanks for watching.